Good day, everyone. We are the group 2 and we're here to discuss our business plan with our product, Ice Cream Chillin.
Introduction. This business is new in the industry, where it provides satisfactions of the target customers. This business surely offers an innovative and affordable product that can reach your expectations. This cream has amazing flavor that bursts into the mouth when eaten. It is made of fresh fruits to enjoy the amazing flavors while having the best benefit of the healthy fruits. The product that the business provides is an ice that is made with a healthy and a fresh fruits. The company decided to make this product for the company wants to satisfy the target customer's cravings that provides vitamins that's good for the body. This product is not just about satisfying one's cravings, but also give them the nutrition and vitamins that their body needs, most especially with today's happenings. Our mission. The business mission is that the business passionate about making innovative product that tastes great and make every eating experience more satisfying and healthy. This business never compromise our product's quality or family values. And we will work each day to succeed customer expectations one order at a time. Our vision. The company's vision is to provide our customer with long-lasting taste or experience in our business, with a creativity, innovation, and originality, and to become the nation neighborhood ice cream parlor. Our goal, to make our customer satisfied and maintain its rich and healthy flavors that can make our customer crave some more, and our business will continue to prosper. Funding requirement. The estimated capital cost for the business products is 1,000 pesos. The equipment used in production are excluded here since it is available already in the homes of the owners, thus ingredients used for productions are included. Market aspect. First is the survey, second is the FEST analysis, and third is the SWOT analysis.
Hi everyone, I'm Alisa Borias and I will discuss you about our marketing plan. As an ice cream parlor, Ice Cream Chillin will be having a big target market. People of all ages, children and adults enjoy delicious and healthy treats. Therefore, it will be subsumed in the target market. The Ice Cream Chillin or our product is very affordable. Therefore, this will be nearly be able to all people regardless to the income. Our product located in a very accessible area that gives business an advantage. The Ice Cream Chillin will be appreciated to all consumers who likes or doesn't like. The Ice Cream Chillin meet the needs and expectation of all consumers.
The third part is the production plan, wherein in this part we'll be able to know what are the materials, what material requirement, the production process, the equipment required, and lastly, the estimated production cost. So first, we're going to know what are the materials that is needed in the product. So first is the banana, carrot, coconut milk, peanut butter, chocolate chips, peppermint extract, dry cocoa powder, disposable cups, and lastly is the popsicle sticks. So these 9 materials is what the business needs for them to be able to produce the product, which is the ice cream. So the company or the business offers 3 different ice cream flavors, which is the minty bum, the banana-licious, and lastly is the carrot ice cream. So next, we'll be able to know the production process. So after making sure that every material is already there, you need to prepare the materials needed. Next is peel the frozen banana, or the carrot, and mix it in the other ingredient using the food processor. So as you can see, the business stated that they need a frozen banana. Why is that? Because according to research, frozen bananas can make the ice cream creamier. So that's why the business really requires to have a frozen banana. So the third process is the grind or wait until the ingredients are totally mixed. So after putting all the ingredients inside the food processor, you need to make sure or you have to make sure that all the ingredients are mixed, totally mixed. So next is that after making sure that it's already mixed, transfer it to the designated ice cream container. So after making sure that it's already mixed, then this will be the time that you're going to put the ice cream or the product inside the container or the disposable cup. Next, put the chosen topping on the ice cream. So the business also offers different toppings for the ice cream, and the customer is going to choose what toppings they want in their ice cream. Lastly is to put it in the freezer and wait till the ice cream is already frozen. So this will be the time that we'll be going to set aside the ice cream or put it inside the freezer and wait until it is frozen, or wait until 24 hours. So next is the equipment required. So we have here three equipments that is needed for the production or for the product. So first is the food processor. So the food processor or the blender is used to mix all the ingredients. Next is the measuring cups. So measuring cups obviously is used for measuring the ingredients, the exact ingredients for the product. So lastly, we have the refrigerator or freezer. So we're going to use it, or the company or the business is going to use refrigerator for freezing the ice cream. Lastly, we'll be able to know the estimated production cost, where the variable cost. So the raw materials are 9 bananas, which it costs 20 pesos. Next is 1 pack of chocolate chips is 109 pesos. 1 can of coconut milk is 40 pesos. 1 half kilo of carrot is 20. 1 bottle of peppermint extract is 65 pesos. 1 pack of dried cocoa is 28 pesos. 1 pack of PepsiCo 6 is 17 pesos. And last is 1 pack of disposable paper cups is 125 pesos. Wherein we can get the total variable, which is the 424 pesos.
Organizational plan, form of business organization. The type of business structure chosen for the business is partnership. That's why the business is owned and operated by two or more persons. The partners invest their money in the business, and that's why each partner benefits from the profits and sustains part of any losses. Proposed salary and wages. Daily, 133.33 pesos. Weekly, 800 pesos. Monthly, 3,200 pesos. We do not get paid every day, but weekly, 160 pesos each, and we are fine. That's why it's 800 pesos. And we do not get paid daily because we focus more on getting paid weekly. And we divided the 160 to 6 days, since 6 days a week is our selling days and Sunday is our day off. That's why our daily wage is 133.33 pesos, because 160 divided by 5 is equal to 26.7, and 26.7 times 5, because we are 5, that's why it's 133.33 pesos. Our weekly wage is 800 pesos because 160 times 5 is equal to 800. And then our monthly wage is 3,200 because there are 4 weeks in 1 month, and that's why we multiply the 800 pesos into 4 weeks, and the answer is 3,200 pesos.
And now let's move on with our financial plan. So we have two denominations, right? That is discussed by my group mates. So we have the 10 peso, which is our smallest size, and we have 15 pesos, which is our largest size. And we have the sizes, just like I said, the small and the large. And our flavors, we have 3 flavors, that is called mint chilin, banana chocolate chilin, and carrot chilin. So those 3 are our flavors. And quality is, we make sure that our ingredients are fresh, because I think that fresh is much more flavorful than the other ones that aren't fresh. And the next, we have the packaging. So we have these small paper cups for our ice cream. So our capital is 1,000 pesos. Why is that? Because, so that is discussed by our introduction. That 1,000 is used for the ingredients and for the materials that are needed, such as paper cups and popsicle sticks and the bananas, carrots, and more. And we did not include our equipments because it is already owned by the owners. And now let's move on with our monthly expense. So we have our fixed cost. So what's our fixed cost? We have the operating expense, which is our transportation expense. So based on my calculations, the fare between my house to the market is 15 pesos, and from the market to our house is another 15 pesos, which is a total of 30 pesos. So that 30 pesos, we will buy new ingredients every once a week. So we have monthly expense, right? So in a month, it is composed of 4 weeks, right? So 30 pesos, 30 pesos, 30 pesos, 30 pesos. So 30 times 4 is 120, right? So that is our transportation expense or our fixed cost. That is, again, 120 pesos. Now let's continue with our variable cost. First, we have our raw materials, which is 18 bananas, 60 pesos. 3 packs of chocolate chips, which is 327 pesos. 2 cans of coconut milk, which is 120 pesos. 1 half kilo of carrot, which is 120 pesos. 1 bottle of peppermint extract, which is 65 pesos. 2 packs of dried cocoa, which is 84 pesos. 3 packs of popsicle sticks, which is 51 pesos, which give us with our total variable cost 827 pesos. And now let's bring it together with our total fixed cost, which is 120 pesos, and our total variable cost, which is 827 pesos, which give us a total of 947 pesos. And that is our monthly expense. Now let's continue with our projected December. So propose we're selling this December. And we have two charts over here, right? We have our selling price 10 pesos and our selling price 15 pesos. Now, this is only for a single flavor. So we have 3 flavors in total, right? So this will be multiplied by 3. But now let's focus first with our 1 flavor. You can think of any flavor that we have. Now let's have the first chart, which is our selling price is 10 pesos. So 10 pesos, our daily volume for that is 5. So again, this is only for a 1 flavor. So that 5 times our selling price, which is 10, so that is equals to 50. So that is our weekly volume, daily revenue. And now we have our weekly volume, that is 5 times 6 working days, that is equals to 30. And that 30 times 10, which is our selling price, that is equals to 300, that is our weekly revenue. And our monthly revenue, that is 300 times 4 weeks in a month, that is equals to 1,200 pesos. Now let's continue with the second chart, which is our selling price is 15 pesos. So again, our daily volume is 5, and 5 times our selling price 15 is equals to 75. And our for our weekly volume, we have 5 times 6 working days is also 30, and 30 times our selling price is 15 is equals to 450. And that we have our monthly revenue, 450 times 4 weeks in a month, that is equals to 1,800. So all of those will be multiplied by 3 since we have 3 flavors. So that is daily volume is 30, daily revenue is 375, our weekly volume is 180, our weekly revenue is 2,250, and our monthly revenue is 9,000. And now let's proceed with our income statement. So our sales is 2,250, which is our weekly revenue. And for our cost of goods sold, we have our raw materials, which is total of 827 pesos. So that is 2,250 pesos minus 827 pesos, which give us a total of 1,423 pesos. And that is our net sales. Now we have our net sales, right? So net sales minus our operating expense, which is 120 pesos for our transportation expense, which give us a total of 1,303 pesos. So that is our net profit for the product. So that is our business plan. We are the group 2 and our product is ice cream chillin. So if you have questions for us and any clarifications, you can comment down below and we will answer it, of course. So thank you again for listening. Bye bye.